The Miro Advanced Simulation mobile unit, it's been just overwhelmingly successful. We're providing training throughout Northeast Indiana, working with Fort Wayne Fire, New Haven, DeKalb counties, EMS providers throughout Northeast Indiana, and even outside of our Parkview family. Some of the main goals for the simulations are just to be able to take it out to the community. A lot of services we work with, they're not able to come to our lab because they're on duty, so we're going to their facilities and taking the training to them. So when we show up, generally what happens for the day is we'll arrive, we'll get all of our equipment set up. We'll go through an orientation process with the people that we're training so they become a little bit familiarized with the mannequin, because a lot of times this is going to be the first time that they've ever worked with something like this, and they're generally pretty amazed. You know, when you feel pulses, you can listen to heart sounds, you can listen to breath sounds, you see them actually breathing. We'll wear a headset during the scenario. We'll actually talk to and interact with the care provider as if we were a real patient. Next step, we'll generally have them go off and, go through their normal day. They're at the fire station. The scenarios we just recently did, somebody comes in and have their blood pressure checks and has a heart attack, something that could realistically happen. So then they will go through that scenario, and we train them, do it live, do it exactly like you would, as if this was really happening. Then after, once the scenario is done, we'll go into another location for the debriefing process with our simulation specialist, and he or she will guide them through, how'd you feel during the scenario? What do you think about what went on? What do you think went right? What would you change differently the next time? And we always ask them for a takeaway. What'd you take away from this experience? People saying, that was really stressful, to that was really cool, to, it's their takeaway is that, I'm not gonna forget that the next time. We've had a number of people say over the time, it's kind of like that, I'm gonna remember that from simulation.
I've done this one other time, and every time it helps quite a bit. And the critiquing after the fact, you can realize what you did wrong or what went right or what we could have done different. We've had scenarios just like that where you're talking to somebody and they go into full rest. So if we're sharp on our skills and we know how to act fast and get stuff done, training never really hurts anybody. It's good to stay up on your skills. I mean, it's required. Not just a requirement, it's the right thing to do.
I think the biggest surprise with Mobile Simulation Lab has been how incredibly popular it's been. I think what it means to the community is almost immeasurable. The fact that we're able to provide that constant, ongoing high level of training to first responders and, emergency personnel within all of Northeast Indiana. We're able to raise that level of training that much more and in turn the care to the patient. And it's, in the end, it's about the patient outcome, patient safety, and their well-being.